making me stronger, shaking me right to the core. Oh, I don't know what's in the stars. I never heard it from above. The world isn't ours, but I know what's in my heart.
Gives this bride away. You may be seated. Brittany, Adam, today you enter as individuals, but you'll leave here as husband and wife, blending your lives, expanding your family ties, and embarking upon the grandest adventure of human interaction. The story of your life together is still yours to write. The Bible has given us what may be the world's best definition of what it means to love. I'd like to share with you a well-known passage from 1 Corinthians 13 and offer it as a model to you for the new life you are creating here today. Love is patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's faults, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope. It is always ready to endure whatever comes. True love does not come to an end. Love is the reason why this day was chosen by you both to begin your lives together, and love is the reason why you both will give with all your hearts for the good of each other. Love is the reason that together you will become one. One in hope, one in believing in life, one in sharing the coming years. Before you are joined in marriage, I am to remind you of the solemn and enduring nature of the relationship into which you are about to enter. To you, Adam, take Brittany to be your lawfully wedded wife from this day forward, to have and to hold, for richer and poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish for so long as you both shall live.
I do.
Brittany, do you take Adam to be your husband, to have and to hold, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, and to cherish for so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Brian, may I have the ring? Adam, take this ring, and in putting it on Brittany's finger, repeat after me. We're going to bless them first. Now I ask God that God bless these rings. May I have the other ring? May these rings be blessed as a symbol of this affectionate union. These two lives are now joined in one unbroken circle. Wherever they go, may they always return to one another in their togetherness. May these two find in each other the love for which all men and women yearn. May they grow in understanding and in compassion. May the home which they establish together be such a place of sanctuary that many will find there a friend. May these rings on their fingers symbolize a touch of the spirit of love in their hearts. Adam, repeat after me. With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
And with all I am and all I have.
And with all I am and all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
And Brittany, in taking this ring, turn his hand just a little bit. Repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all I am and all I have.
With all I am and with all I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Awesome. You can take hands. May I have the parents of the bride and groom come? This cord symbolizes an infinite bond of love you share that keeps your relationship strong in the face of adversity. I would ask that you always treat yourself with each other with respect and remind yourselves often of what brought you together today. Adam, Brittany, you have sealed your relationship by the giving and receiving of rings. And this is a pledge between two people who agree that they will commit themselves to one another throughout their lives. Now let us also do an exchange of the coins, also known as aras. There you go. Okay, I'm going to speak for a moment. Originally, there was an understanding of husband as breadwinner and wife as homemaker. So the coins were given and received not in a spirit of reciprocity, but in the give and take relationship. Nowadays, the coins are a reminder of good stewardship for all couples, and they will mutually support each other, their children, and the world around them. May God bless these coins that symbolize mutual support and responsibility. Adam, repeat after me. Brittany.
Brittany.
I give you these coins.
I give you these coins.
As a ledge of my dedication to you.
As a ledge of my dedication to you.
The care of our home.
The care of our home.
And the welfare of our children.
And the welfare of our children.
You can put them in Brittany's hands. And Brittany, you're going to give them back. So repeat after me. Adam.
Adam.
I give you these coins as a pledge.
I give you these coins as a pledge.
Of my dedication to you.
As my dedication to you.
The care of our home.
The care of our home.
And the welfare of our children.
And the welfare of our children.
And then you give them back to your dad. Adam, Brittany, today you've exchanged promises. You have exchanged rings. You have done the lasso and aras ceremony. And in this time, you want to remember this day. You want to remember those promises that you've made to each other. You want to remember as you look at your rings that you're looking at each other's hearts and the unbroken love you have. You want to remember that you've been bound in love and that you've promised you've promised each other to uphold those things by the exchanging of the coins. And so by the power vested in me by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Adam, you may kiss the bride. It is my great honor to be the first to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Adam Fowler.
Kiss you when I'm gone, so I'm gonna love you now like it's all.